Hello. Adelaid McDevitt?
If you're hungry, there's meat turning on the spit outside. If you're bearing illness, find a place to lay your head down and I'll fetch you a poultice.
Oh,
whatever
thank you.
Your troubles with Edgewater, leave them at the gates and be welcomed here. Any questions, dear?
So these people, yeah, left Edgewater. They don't agree somehow. Just who are you now?
Suppose that weighs on who's asking. My flock likes to call me grandmother on account of my providing hot soup and free advice. You can call me Adelaid, though. Are you staying long? You should try some of my tobaccorn tea. I brew it in an old spittoon, but it's been cleaned.
Huh. So you look just like an older version of the lady who's looking for that girl who's like, wouldn't let me in here at first. Is this your greenhouse?
No, dear. The garden belongs to us all. Life is the gift of the universe, and the universe yields its bounty equally, absent of prejudice.
I'm surprised you've managed to grow anything out here.
The soil around the Vale went sour years ago, but I found a way to sweeten it back up. The secret recipe is a little bit of elbow grease, a dash of love, and a heaping pile of special fertilizer.
Hmm. Looks like you've made a home for yourself out here.
A home for anyone who's ever turned their backs on Edgewater. A home for those of us with nowhere left to go and nothing to lose. So, like the spores of the puffball cast on the wind and alighting on fresh soil, we put down new roots.
Okay, so here's the question I've actually been wondering. What do people have against Edgewater? Why did you leave your old home?
It is an unpleasant story, dear. But the short of it is that sometimes one wakes up and realizes the place that was once her home for much of her life has changed.
Hmm.
The home in which we spent our lives has left us behind, and so we must move on. And that is as much as I will say on the subject.
So Edgewater has changed somehow. This might sound strange, but I don't know where I am.
That's not strange at all, dear. Few of us truly know where we are. The world can seem like a forest without end, and it is all too easy to lose one's way.
Hmm.
But we must remember that being lost is the first step in discovering yourself.
Yeah. No, I mean I actually don't know where I am.
This is the old botanical lab in Emerald Vale, on Terra 2. By the look on your face, I'm guessing you're not quite following me. Are you not feeling well? Ought to lay your head down if you're running fever.
I was kidnapped by a crazy scientist and shot into space, but thanks for asking.
That sounds like fever talk, all right. So why am I tempted to believe you? Where did you say you were from?
Does the Hope ring any bells?
Is that a new settlement of some kind? I haven't kept news from outside the Vale.
Not exactly. It's a colony ship.
Oh, you're talking about that old piece of folklore.
Oh, God.
Now I'm convinced you're delirious. You really ought to lay your head down, dear. Babbling only agitates the humors. You ought to try some of my purgative tea. Won't cure what ails you, but it will distract you for a spell.
It's only been 70 years. So, you don't believe me?
Maybe I do. I don't know yet. Growing up, I heard my folks talking about the Hope. Always believed it was just a story we told ourselves to keep our spirits up. Listen, don't you worry about what I think. That's not important. Worry about what the board thinks of you going around talking about lost ships from decades past.
Why? I haven't done anything wrong.
You carry on about coming here from another world, and people will talk. Talk leads to questions. Ask enough questions, and the board comes answering.
I'm not afraid of the board.
No, but the board may have reason to fear you.
Sounds good. Just talk about something else, then?
I'm listening.
Or I should go. That's pretty aggressive. Oh, you could play chess here. I thought that was a body covered for a second. This is another way out. Or did I actually come in? No, I think I came in that way. Oop.
Hey, I saw. What do you think you're doing?
I have a bunch of money, right? That persuade is pretty high. I'll pay 170 bits to look the other way. Your reputation with the faction has changed. If enemies are hostile, but your reputation isn't killed on sight, leaving for a few days will calm things down. Oh, I lost my bit cartridge. Oh no, that's my my money. Deserter's reputation decreased. I figure she didn't see me. So I guess I just can't go around opening everything.
I'm listening.
So I get to keep the shunt then? Is this okay to use? Or will I get in trouble for this too? When life gives you lemons, consider it a free trial or something? Emerald Vale Botanical Lab and Experimental Facility. Personal files? Personal files? Yeah. Password required. Hack 10 for bypass. Password Silent Spring accepted. Welcome A. McDevitt. First entry. May the Eternal bless my first endeavor. It's been 2 days since I walked away from life at the Edgewater Cannery. Fortuitously, the old botanical labs are still operational. Mostly. The soil's sour. I'll do what I can, but I'm going to need some powerful fertilizer. Tired of having the taste of salt tuna lingering on my tongue, day in, day out. I want something fresh. Something that grows out of the earth. Well, then you've found the right place. Last entry. We found another worker from Edgewater. Ex-worker now. Desertion rates must be climbing. I'm not terribly surprised. Reed's style of management has always been tyrannical. I imagine an exodus is brewing. At any rate, the worker was in a sorry state. Fever, shallow breathing, delirious. Must have been plagued. I set him right with his diet of greens. He was all better in a couple weeks. Physically, spiritually, he's one of our flock now. Experimental notes. First entry. I am hereby repurposing this botanical lab from its original conception as a gear in the soulless automaton of the corporate machine. This greenhouse may look impressive, but like all Spacer's Choice products, it is cheap and unreliable. I shall have to make some repairs with my own two hands. This place shall become a nursery. Before it was abandoned, I understand the horticulturists failed to produce a single viable crop. Something about the soil being too poor. I am determined to find a way. May the Eternal smile upon my endeavors. Last entry. Flora are living things, as sensitive to their environment as any breathing, thinking body. I contend that the crops in this region fail because the corporate scientists tending to them are cold, heartless, inhumane people acting on behalf of a sterile and inhumane power. One cannot expect your crops to flush with green and reach for the sky under these conditions. The soil is sour, it's true. I don't know quite how to explain that. I'm sure the scientists will say something about biology or the carbon cycle. But I can conclude, after months of my own experimentation, that the secret to a rich and wholesome garden is love, attention, compassion, and a natural fertilizer bursting with organic materials, just as nature intended. What does Tab do? Oh, exit? Oh. Tab is exit. Oh, my. Cool. So where is she? She's still out here? Where are you, lady? She is still out there, okay. So hopefully she won't see me doing this. Oh, these look like those things I fought. Yeah, terror rays. Biological overview. Let's go outside. Shears. Think industrial strength scissors. Industrial long bladed shears that make for a very handy slicing weapon when in a pinch. Okay. Zoe's journal, page 22. Well, today's the day, Zoe. Today's the day you take your destiny into your own hands. I've been listening to Grace talk about the Marauder threat. Bands of wild, free-spirited bandits living in camps out in the hills, warming themselves by the light of barrel fires, probably mounted the heads of their enemies on spikes as a warning folk like me. Living a life of comfort and ease, free of any rules, but they could take the whole region if they were organized. I've been tucking away some of Adelaide's food, and I've got some spare cans of salt tuna. Should last me a couple weeks if I ration. Got some Adrena time, too. Everybody loves Adrena time. Even Marauders, right? I got odds those Marauders will let me throw in with them if I dangle a couple of syringes of old Adrena time before their eyes. This is gonna be great. Look out, Terra 2. Bandit Queen Zoe's origin story has just begun. I'm gonna have a whole gang of Marauders at my beck and call. Maybe I can even score some Rizzos. So she did voluntarily go. Search Zoe's home for clues. That's where we are, Zoe's home. Not this one. Page 13, I mean page 12 of the journal. So that's it then. No more Edgewater for me. No more cannery. No more jumpsuits and gloves. Yes ma'ams, and would you like another's? I don't know why I'm writing this down for posterity's sake. Because I've always hated the cannery, and I don't think I'll ever have to look back to this journal many years hence and tell myself, oh wow, I did hate the Vale once, didn't I? Just because I got sick. Everybody gets sick. Well, okay, I got sick and grabbed a little too much Adrena time. Is that really a crime? I gotta treat myself when I'm sick, don't I? Whatever happened to personal responsibility and surviving by one's own bootstraps? Oh, but you misappropriate one box of Adrena Time, and suddenly you're committing larceny. Here's another page. Page 18. Good news. I'm alive. Starting to feel a little better, too. There's a group of deserters living out in the old botanical labs. They found a way to grow some food, or something that passes for food anyway. Adelaid boiled a pot of something green and leafy and told me to drink it twice a day for my symptoms, I suppose. Tastes atrocious, but I've been feeling better. It's nice to be away from the cannery. The labs have just enough power to run on ether wave, so I've been catching up on my serial dramas. Mass marketeer, what would I do without you? Go crazy, most likely. Crack up, murder all my neighbors, and run screaming into the hills, like some wild marauder. I don't know. Doesn't sound too bad. I could see myself leading a couple of marauders. A band of bandits? Wait, it doesn't sound right. Band of bandits? What do we call ourselves? The Formidable 14. The 100 Hooligans, featuring Zoe, Bandit Queen. So she's been wanting to join them. What's this? Oh, sleep? I can sleep there. Oh. Take the poster, really? Terror on Monarch, with Ruth Bellamy as Halcyon Helen, Spencer Woolrich as Chief of the Savages, featuring real monsters from the doomed world. 12 amazing episodes. Oh, I stole the poster. Any more pages? Let's see any more. Well, it's not even junk. Zoe's journal. Your reputation with a faction is changed. If enemies are hostile, but your reputation isn't kill on sight, leaving for a few days will calm things down. The people of Halcyon have short memories. That's what that said. One of Zoe's journal entries revealed that she secretly planned to run away and join the Marauder camp to the east. Now that you know her location, head to the camp and see if she's okay. Grace doesn't know where Zoe might have gone. She suggested checking the shack where Zoe beds down for any hints of where she might have gone. Stefan said that Zoe kept the journal, which should be in her quarters. Stefan revealed that he was looking forward to surprising Zoe with an episode of her favorite serial. Grace said that out of all the people in the camp, Stefan was the one closest to Zoe and might know something about her disappearance. Yeah, I had a feeling, for some reason, that she did join them.
Something I can help you with?
I got some more questions about Zoe.
I'll help if I can.
No, I guess...
Hey, I got time.
No, I guess I don't have an option to tell him that she apparently voluntarily joined them. Alright, we still have more to look around this area. It's turned to day and then back to night again.
If you're hungry, Stefan's got supplies.
So all this keeps going to the... Yeah.
If you're hungry, Stefan's got supplies.
Keep your wits about you, friend.
But what if I'm hungry? What do I do then? Oh, we got in here. Jeez. 23 mock apples. By patient. Two of them. A necklace. To attack me. And then I went up there. Workbench discovered. Oh, sweet. I thought that was a workbench. Power regulator! Ooh. Ouch. Can I turn this crap off so I can pick it up? Wouldn't think it would be that easy though, you know? Come on. Thank you. Thomas Kemp.
Oh, didn't see you there. I was, well, I was just occupying myself with a little engineering. Sorry about that. Machines are cantankerous by nature, liable to take insult and blow a fuse at the slightest mishandling. Are you from town? I mean, you don't exactly look like you're from town.
Just trying to get my ship off the ground.
Never heard it phrased in such a way before. I guess we're all trying to get our ships off the ground, ain't we?
No,
sorry, I just wasn't sure if you were from town or if you were one of us. Something's been chewing at me, you see. Fact is, I've been, well, lying to everybody here. Camp thinks I'm a mechanical genius, but I couldn't fix a busted chair.
Never too late to start learning. I could give you a couple pointers.
I'll take all the help I can get. I set my mind to learning the craft of the engineer, you see. I want to make something of myself. You ever heard of the Young Spacer's Guide to Mechanical Engineering? Hmm. Comes in a set of three. If I had my hands on one of those data pads, I could teach myself the ins and outs. There's one in the old community center. Should find one back in town, too. Parvati's dad had a copy. He used to take it with him when he worked at the cannery before he passed.
Hmm. I just came from the community center. You mentioned two pads. What about the third?
I wish I knew. I wager the town had the full set once upon a time. Where the third's gone, I can't say.
I expect a fair price for my trouble.
I'll pay you for every pad you bring me. If, by some miracle, you can bring me the full set, I'll give you something pretty I've been saving for a lucky day.
Hmm. I'll let you know if I find anything.
Would you? I'd be grateful.
I want to ask you something.
What's on your mind?
You say you pretended to be an engineer. How have you been getting away with it?
Luck, mostly. Nothing's needed serious repairing yet. Nothing's broken down that we can't just replace with something scavenged from the outskirts. Oh, I can swap out a water filter or charge up a battery and go on pretending I know what I'm doing. But the moment I'm asked to do any real engineering, I'm in trouble.
How long have you lived here?
Couple months. This camp's my home. People you see milling about, they're my family. At least I think of them that way. I owe them my life. Would have died in the wilderness if they hadn't chanced upon me, starving and delirious.
What were you doing out in the wilderness?
We all left the cannery for one reason or another. Me? I was let go. Mostly on account of my incompetence. I mean, I was incompetent. I couldn't even survive on my own. Grace found me, Adelaid took me in, I've been on my feet ever since.
There I should go. And that's the workbench. I'm not gonna be messing with that just yet. Can't go in there. Well, there's two buildings. It's so dark over here. Hopefully you guys can see anything. I'm having trouble seeing. Came from there. What's this? Did I go here? Yeah. This is back. Okay. Oh, thankfully it's getting lighter now. I guess we've seen it all here. Do you have a name for this place? Do I have the option? I guess it's the botanical lab town, huh?
What is it? I'll tell you what I can.
Yeah, I don't have a chance to tell her.
What is it?
I'll leave it be. At least we can see now. Oh, got marauders. So we'll be heading for the marauder town next, which is this way, according to what they're saying to the east. That, we have fast travel here, too. This is where Zoe went to, voluntarily, apparently. So, we'll be checking that out next episode. I really only meant to record for, like, about an hour, and I've got 2 hours here. So I want to thank you guys so much for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.